Is it still possible to become a full stack developer? This is a question I get asked so much, and it really got me thinking. Is it still possible? To become a full stack developer, there is so much you need to know, so many different technologies from front end, back end, databases, servers, and so much more. It almost feels like this isn't even a possibility anymore. Today, I'm going to share with you my thoughts on if this is possible to become a full stack developer. Before we get there though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. Thank you for your comments, questions, feedback, and just being amazing. Also, before we get started, I want to say a big thank you to Soundcore for sponsoring part of this video. They just released their new Liberty 3 Pro wireless noise-canceling earbuds. They are incredible. I'm currently wearing them right now. I've been wearing them. I mean, if you've been following me for a while now, you know I have dogs running through my house. I have people coming and going. Like, it's madness, and I'm trying to sit and focus and code. So having good earbuds that are noise canceling, I can totally focus and feel like I am zen is, you can't put a price on that. It's so key. Also, I have tried so many different active noise canceling headphones or earbuds, and I have to say the best sound comes out of these ones. They have fusion comfort factor to them. So the earbuds when in the ear are comfortable for wearing for a long period of time, and they are securely fit. So you can go running with them, coding with them, any of the above. Also, I love how they have up to 32 hours of playtime for long lasting play. I have the dusk purple color, but they also come in fog gray, frost white, and midnight black. I've linked them down in the description, so make sure to go check them out if you are looking for some amazing wireless noise canceling earbuds. They are honestly, I love how, because I used to have a lot of pairs where one would be for office, for daytime, one would be for, say, if I'm going for a workout or for different occasions, and I love how these can be kind of used across the board. Okay, let's get started. Is it still possible to become a full stack developer? I think this question really can be answered as to what your definition of a full stack developer is. So before we get into answering the question, let's see what Google has to say. Not saying Google's always right, but just so we have a good standardized definition for this video anyways as to what a full stack developer is. What is a full stack developer? Okay, this is the first result that comes up, might be different from you, but let's see what they say here. What skills are required? Okay, it's a long list, I'm just warning you. Let's see. Okay, so a full stack developer is someone who works with the backend or server side of the application as well as the front end or client side. Full stack developers have to have some skills in many areas of coding, from databases to graphic design to UI UX management in order to do their job well. This is from Lee Wagen or Lo Wagen. And I agree with that mostly. I don't really think graphic design fits in there, but I'm curious to know, what is your definition of a full stack developer? Would you agree with this? Is there something you would add or take away? A lot of times when we talk about full stack developers, we can get really ingrained in the details by talking about they should be this mythical unicorn that can do everything under the sun. And I think it's important to remember that you can't necessarily include other roles in this role. And what I mean by that is, yes, they should have, you know, some DevOps skills, some designer skills, some QA skills, but you can't expect them to be proficient in different roles, because that's not what a full stack developer is. And I think that's really important to keep in mind, because I think sometimes the waters can get a little muddy there. But that being said, it's one of those things that so many people, when they are starting out their coding journey, they have these dreams of becoming a full stack developer. And why? Well, one would be the pay. There's great pay for full stack developers. The other is demand. It's very in demand. And the third being, it's kind of like this, as I mentioned, this mythical unicorn that almost feels like you'll never be able to achieve it. So here are my thoughts if it is still possible. My first and quick answer is kind of. And what I mean by that is, if you are someone who is looking to become a full stack developer in 2021, 2022, 2023, one thing you need to really keep in mind is it's probably not going to be your first job. And if it is, you probably won't do that great at it. Let me explain. What I mean is, yes, it is possible to become a full stack developer, but just like anything, it comes with experience. You need to really understand the front end of things, the back end of things, a server side, and so much more. And in order to have a really good understanding of all, and I'm not just talking about knowing the definitions or, you know, worked on the server once or front end once, but you really have to have dove into different areas to consider yourself a full stack developer. And I'm sorry if that's like breaking some hearts right now for people who are aspiring developers wanting to become a full stack right out of the gate. But even though you can definitely touch the front and back right when you start, I don't think you're going to be touching every aspect that is considered a full stack developer. And I think that's really important to keep in mind because it goes back to what we talk a lot about in these videos, which is ensuring your expectations are aligned with your reality, with your skill set. Are you someone that is capable of at this moment being a full stack developer? Do you need more experience? Where is your skill set? I think you definitely have to have a few years of experience either in the front end, back end, preferably in both, to even apply for full stack developer roles. Now that being said, there are always the exceptions. My first job as a software developer was actually titled full stack developer, although 99.9% of what I did was the back end side of things. I didn't even really touch the front end, but because it was my title on paper and because I once in a blue moon would touch the front end, that's kind of what happened. But would I consider it really a true full stack developer in my first role? Probably not. And I still think there is so much I need to learn to become this mythical unicorn full stack developer that although I feel very proficient with the front end, back end, and a lot of other areas, there are still so much areas that I need to work on. And maybe that's imposter syndrome creeping in and taking a hold, but I really wanted to cover this question today with you because it's so easy to think that, you know, to just write off that you'll never be a full stack developer, you should pick either front end or back end, but whatever you choose to start with, whether it's front end, back end, or really anything, you don't have to stick with whatever it is that you necessarily pick up first, whether it be front end or back end, you can always switch and those skills will still be applicable in some way or the other. You're not just completely throwing out your skill set that you committed to at first. So don't become overwhelmed that there is so much out there to learn. Really hone in on one technology and kind of focus on getting that skill developed before you move on to the next. Because in order to be a successful full stack developer at the end of the day anyways, you'll need to have multiple skills. So step by step, it's building blocks. Thank you all for watching this video. I hope you really enjoyed it and got some insight as to if it's possible to be a full stack developer and really my thoughts on the topic. If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Also, make sure to click the link in the description for these amazing earbuds. Once again, they are honestly my go-to. Like, I have all my meetings in them now. And I'm a huge walker when I do meetings. Like, I'll go outside, go for a walk, and take a meeting if it's not too technical related. So it's kind of a win-win. Anyways, I will see you all very soon. Thanks for watching.